If you want an instant messenger with all the features of Skype and Discord that also respects your privacy, download Talks, a new kind of instant messaging. My Talks ID will be in the video description. Enjoy. Hey guys, GWizard here, and welcome to Free Factory 27, where I pick three crappy and or mediocre free-to-play games and give them what they deserve. A thrashing. Sorry, I ran out of things to say at this point. Anyway, we're going to take a look at Android games again, and I handpicked three terrible games. But first, I got two dishonorable mentions. The first dishonorable mention goes to Final Fantasy XV Pocket Edition. I put this in the dishonorable mention category because I usually don't tackle big games on this show. Keyword, usually. The key point to Final Fantasy XV Pocket Edition is its questionable graphical style that makes it look like it's come out of a PS2 game. Seriously, go compare Pocket Edition with the real Final Fantasy XV and you'll see what I mean. The second bad thing is that it's on Unity, which should already be a big red flag as it is. And you know how I feel about the Unity engine, so I won't go into detail once again. The second dishonorable mention is a terrible Super Mario Bros. Ripoff called Caillou Adventures, which has Caillou and GoAnimate style on a skateboard as the sprite. I couldn't get that one because it was actually taken down from the Google Play Store. Whether that's for better or for worse, you be the judge. Okay, now we're going to get into the three games I display here. And this one is going to be in portrait mode, and this will be a good time to bring this up. If anyone knows of a good free screen recorder for Android, please let me know in the comments section. As we go into our first game, Emoji Game. Yeah, a game based off the Emoji Movie, or as I like to call it, the Cringe Movie. Pretty much everyone and their grandmother has thrashed it, so I'm not going to go into detail again. The Emoji Movie game, Pop Frenzy. Yeah, I remember a quote from someone, I can't remember. If you want to make a game from a property, it has to be a successful property. Like a Disney movie or something. Not something as terrible as the Cringe Movie. And I believe I had the volume turned down. Let me turn it up. Yeah, I'm trying to turn it up, but lag is getting to me. That is too loud, I apologize. Anyway, the music is utter crap. But what do you expect when it came out of a Cringe Movie? Alright, let's play. Unlimited... sorry, limited lives? Yeah, this sucks already. Ain't gotta load. Here we go. So, this is a Bust a Move ripoff. And yeah, Bust a Move is already on the App Store for $5, so why not leave that genre alone? Taito's already got it covered, for God's sake. But what makes this ripoff interesting is that instead of being based off clearing a level, it's based off getting a high score, which not many ripoffs tackle. Except this one is filled with, as I said, cringe. And you know how everyone feels about this kind of thing. And also, another bad point of the game is that you cannot lose. Watch, I'm gonna try to lose on purpose. I'm trying to lose on purpose, but it automatically shifts up. How can you call this a game if you can't even lose? What is this? Mario is missing? Yeah. You see, I got 103,000. Yeah. Because you can't even goddamn lose. Hey, look. I got little piece of shit. Yeah, that little piece of shit is a little piece of shit, and this game is a big piece of shit. In other words, the game sucks. As well as the Emoji Movie itself. Okay, now that I got that out of the way, time to rotate to the landscape style. So, be right back. Okay, I am back, and it's time to tackle our second game. Sonic's World. Sonic's World? Isn't that Kirby? The hell? It's rotated. You gotta be kidding me. Fine, I'll rotate it. It's not easy having to do this in the dark. Okay, so, yeah. So let's play. Alright, let's go to level 1. Oh no. This looks familiar. I think I played a game like this. But instead of Kirby, it was a character from Cuphead. Yeah. It even has the same signs of text and the same shitty scrolling. Yeah. You can even stomp on enemies. Doesn't Kirby usually inhale his enemies, not stomp on them? Yeah. And look, they even tried to make a Wispy Woods ripoff. If you look carefully, you could see a little face on him. Yeah. Yeah. Very cool. You know what's cool? These people actually making an original effing game. And Kirby doesn't collect coins, he collects stars. Haven't these people ever done their research? This is like that one Zelda ripoff, where apparently the enemies can steal the Master Sword. Yeah. And he even got that same old man over there. And he even has the same text. Kirby in this one is apparently called Layla, and he can talk. So, they have done their research. They play Kirby's Avalanche. Yeah. They really need to play the other Kirby games, though. And Kirby can wall jump? What is this madness? And look, there's not Wispy Woods again. I wonder if Alpha Rad will do a will do an episode on Not Kirby and feature this. I hope so. There's a little hint for Alpha Rad if he's watching this. Anyway, time to move on to the last game. And this one is going to be interesting. This one is Pokemon Quest. As I said earlier, I usually don't cover big games, but this one is an exception. And I'll tell you why later. So, let the game load for a second. Yeah, it's right, we're on a loading screen. Okay. Yeah, I'm trying to whistle. I'm trying to think of things to pass the time while it loads up. And believe me, when these mobile games take long to load, you know you're in for a trip. Come on! This tablet has 2 gigs of RAM. And it can't even load quick. The audio might be a bit loud. Of course, online only DRM. You know, actually, the way the game handles the DRM is kind of weird. And again, I'll go into that later. Take off airplane mode. There we go. Let's try again. But I'm connected. What the hell? No one reads those. No one reads those. God damn it, let me click yes. Shut up, tablet. I don't care about the interactions from Twitter. Arg. There we go, finally. God damn, this game wants to know everything. This game wants you to know everything. Man. One of these days, these games are going to ask for your freaking shirt size or something. Or your social security number. This application can be paid and played in full without spending any money. Yeah, right. And I believe now we can turn off the internet. There we go. I'm headed for a small island that was recently discovered called Tumble Cube Island. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, and there's no option to skip the cutscene. Yeah. In a world where cutscenes can be skipped, you can't skip cutscenes. That's good. I like my unskippable cutscenes. You know, Alpha Rat has made a strange conspiracy. Where games have been taken down and Nintendo follows up on a similar concept. I mean, Project M was taken down due to legal pressure, and Nintendo continued updates for Smash 4. AM2R was taken down by Nintendo, but then Nintendo made Metroid Samus Returns for the 3DS. And they recently took down Pixelmon, and then they made this game in place of Pixelmon. And very recently, they took down the fan game creator Pokemon Essentials. Based on what we know so far, is a Pokemon Maker on the horizon? Well, I played Super Mario Maker, and I can say I sure hope not. And yes, Pokemon has drones now. And to quote that one guy from the Kanto games, technology is amazing. And now I have to input my name. Well, I'm going to try to enter this, Pixelmon. Because Nintendo took it down. Oh, guess what? You have to be connected to the internet to enter a name. And it gets even stupider. I'll show you later. Yeah. Come on. Get up there. There we go. Close. I have to enter it again? That's one of this game's many flaws, the way the online DRM was implemented. Pixelmon, right? It actually allows Pixelmon with no punishments. Good. Alright. Now we get into the meat of the game. The gameplay. I like to put that in quotes. Tap the Pokemon I want to befriend. And this is one major problem here. The character designs. They look worse than Pixelmon. Pixelmon's designs were better. But I see Eevee's is the least horrible, so we're going to pick that one. And Pokemon Let's Go is about to come out, so I might as well. Alright. So we can finally get to the gameplay, right? Maybe we could turn the internet off now? There. Okay. Wild Pokemon. And look at this. I didn't even do anything, and it automatically attacked. Yeah. The gameplay in this is basically a shitty version of Pokemon Rumble. And hey look, Force Tutorials. Yeah. I can do nothing, and it attacks. Gameplay! Yeah, this is pretty stupid. Hello, where are the enemies? Finally. Why does it take so long for them to appear? Just attack. You could do nothing, and it attacks well. I hate to say this in front of the camera, in front of everyone, but Pokemon Shuffle had more gameplay than this crap. Look, I'm doing nothing right now. You don't even have to press the move buttons. Game does it for you. And just to insult the player, there's an auto button, which picks the attacks for you. I think it does. See? There it is. It used flail automatically. This boss requires no effort. Easiest first boss ever. See? Proves my point. Yeah, stage cleared. Stage cleared by doing absolutely nothing. Luigi is better than doing absolutely nothing than this garbage. Okay. Time to do some other random shit that the game will force us into. I'm pretty sure everyone hates forced tutorials. Come on, I want to do something else. Nope, you can't do anything else. It's a forced tutorial. Like I said, there's no option to skip it. Yeah. It would have been nice if there were an option to skip all this. So I'm on another stage, and it's time to do nothing and win. Look at this. I'm not doing anything. I'm not putting my hands on the screen. Look at this. Do nothing and win. So much gameplay. Don't you guys agree? You know, suddenly I have a brand new appreciation for Pokemon Shuffle. Jeez, how many Rattatas are there? My god. Not a problem for the Eevee that does nothing to win. And there's a Meowth. What a missed opportunity to put Team Rocket in this. Then again, why would Team Rocket want to be in this shitty game? Beat the stage by doing nothing again. So little gameplay, so little time. As the old saying goes. Yay, time for more forced tutorial bullshit. This time you can cook ingredients. Obviously ripped out of the main Pokemon games. Yeah, they're trying to implement some of the main Pokemon mechanics in this. Doesn't make the game any less shitty, though. Here's some PM tickets. Here's a mobile game trope. They give you a currency, and then they force you to use them, leaving you with nothing. This is a cruel joke. So you automatically get some buddies. Yay, they look terrible. Now I've been wondering, can I quit midway and still be able to do what I want? I've been wondering that. Or do they force you to do nothing through the stage and you can't quit at all? I'm wondering that. Just so I can get around the forced tutorial. Oh, I can't give up, damn it. They do force you to go through it. Well, time to do nothing again. Maybe I should speed this up. Thank you. Another mission done by doing nothing. Yes, yes. Do we have to go through more force tutorials now? No, I don't want to connect to the shop. Oh good. Now this is how the online-only DRM can screw you. In this mandatory tutorial, you have to receive your daily tickets. But if you don't have an internet connection, you can't receive the daily tickets and get out of this forced tutorial. That's a nice design flaw. So let's go ahead and get these tickets. Yep, despite the fact that I have a connection. Oh, now it works. And I'm pretty sure there's no time traveling. You know how these crap DRMs work, so yeah. Alright, finally, we can do whatever we want. Now, let me show you that one fault I was talking about. Yeah, is it on the screen? Yeah, I think it's on the screen. Or, wait. No, I think it's the individual character buttons. This one. Alright, so... yeah, here we go. You can give your Pokemon a nickname, but this is where another problem rises. Nice glitch, by the way. You know that problem where you have to put in your name and you have to connect to the internet to verify your name? Well, if you try to nickname your Pokemon and you have no internet connection, it doesn't work. That's right, you have to be connected to the internet in order to give your Pokemon a nickname. What the fuck is this garbage? The main Pokemon games weren't like that. No. They allow you to nickname your Pokemon anything you want, without an internet connection needed. Well, I'm gonna try to write a parody name. Something forbidden, usually, by the 3DS games. I wonder if this will actually work. Let me see if this actually works. If it does, I'm gonna laugh my ass off. That name cannot be used. Yeah, no surprise there. And you want to know the most shocking part of all this? This game... who do you think this game was made by? Is it made by Genius Sonority? No. Umbrella? No. Select Button? No. It was made by Game Freak themselves. Game Freak themselves made this travesty. Why? Just why? It's crap like this that makes me have very little faith in the Pokemon series nowadays. Free-to-play garbage like this, and Pokemon Quest is undoubtedly the absolute worst. It's terrible. The fact that Game Freak themselves made this is just an absolute travesty. It's worse than Pokemon Shuffle. You do nothing, and you win. At least in Shuffle, you have some control. But in Quest? No. Not at all. Well, I'm done. That was Free Factory 27. We've had a game based off one of the worst time, which ended up to be a bust-the-move-slash-puzzle-bobble ripoff, a clone of a game we already covered, and Pokemon Quest, which is one of the worst free-to-play games of all time. Enough said. So yes, this is G-Wizard signing off. Be sure to subscribe for more videos. And I'm sorry if this part ended up dragging on. You can blame Pokemon Quest with its forced, long-winded tutorials that you need an internet connection for one part. Did I mention that? See you guys later.